Introduction to EdBlocks. In the last video, we learned what Edison's barcode program SumaWrestle does. Starting from this video, we will start controlling Edison with our own programs written using EdBlocks. We will need worksheet number 8. Programming Edison can be done with multiple programming languages. EdBlocks is the easiest of them and suits beginners well. If you have mastered EdBlocks, you can also take a look at Edware and EdPy languages. EdBlocks is completely web-based and can be accessed on the website edblocksapp.com. Pay attention! Since EdBlocks is web-based, you must have an internet connection. I will use a tablet throughout this course, but EdBlocks works very well in a computer too. Let's go to edblocksapp.com. The screen is filled with a white screen, the work window. In this window, we will start writing programs for Edison. How to write a program? It's very simple. A program is like a sentence. It has a beginning and words in the right order. In EdBlocks, words are substituted by pictures. The program starts with the start button, which is yellow and which is left side is round. To create parallel programs, for example, programs running at the same time with the main program, we can use either of the start blocks under the start events section. After the start block, we need to give the robot some commands. As they say, programming a robot is simple, much harder is to come up with what the robot should do. Let's write a program where we give the robot 5 commands. 2 related to driving, 2 related to turning, and 1 related to turning on the LED lamps. Under all commands, we specify how long we want the activity to last for. Driving and turning blocks are located in the Drive menu section. The LED block is located in the menu section Output. To create a program, we need to put the right blocks in order. We can do that by opening the menu section we want a block from, holding our finger on the block and dragging it to place while holding on our finger on it. If there's a white number input connected to the block, then you can edit the value by clicking on the number and typing in a new one. If the block has a triangle under it, then we can do an additional specified choice. If some block is unwanted, we can hold it with a finger and drag it into the bin in the right corner. Another option to delete the block is to hold a finger on the block for a bit until the option Delete Block appears. If the wrong block is in the middle of the program, first drag and disconnect it from the first half of the program together with the second half. Then drag and disconnect the half of the program to the right of the wrong block, and now you can throw the wrong block in the bin and reconnect the halves. Putting blocks in between other blocks is simply done by dragging them to the connection joint of two blocks. My program will be like this. Drive forward for 1.3 seconds, turn to the right for 0.4 seconds, turn on both LEDs, drive backwards for 0.9 seconds and finally, turn to the right for 1.5 seconds. As you saw, there was no seconds option under the LED block. This means the LEDs will now be turned on until we turn them back off. And the program is finished. We will learn how to upload it to the robot in the next video. Now it's your turn. Complete the challenge on the screen and see you in the next video. Challenge. Use your tablet or computer to open the website edblocksapp.com. Open different menus and see which blocks are located in them. Try to compose a program which consists of at least 3 blocks. Also, try deleting a block. Did finding programming blocks from the menu and connecting into a program seem easy? The material will be easier to memorize if you print out and solve worksheet number 8.